And I'm back with another review. Now, this has been a long time coming. I've been waiting for the Pirates of the Caribbean ship to come out from Revell, and it's finally available. Revell Germany, 112 parts, 1/150th scale, 26 centimeters long, 23.5 centimeters tall, from Revell Germany. This is an easy click kit, which is just the new term for snap tight. Do not be a snap tight snob, or you're gonna miss out on a lot of nice kits out there. The technology is really nice these days. We're gonna be taking a look at a lot of these parts. They're pre-colored, but I'm gonna be doing some tricks and tips during this review to show us how we can take pre-colored parts with a little bit of work and just add some more detail to them. You can see the beautiful sails, and the detail on them is just lovely. We've got these fine rat lines and shrouds for being molded out of plastic. Super fine. Really nice looking. We got our big anchors there. No flash to even mention. No flash to clean out in between all of those. Nice tight molding. Beautiful look to it. We got another deck here with some cannon. We've got some crow's nests. We've got separate cannons for the upper deck. And the lower deck has cannon molded in, because we're pretty much not going to see it. It's just there to hold those cannon. We've got our fine masts on this tree. Look at the molding on that nowadays. Pretty amazing. And I love me some ships, and it's been a long time since I've done a ship on the channel, so I couldn't wait to grab a hold of this model and get it built up. Now, you can build it as it is right out of the box, or you can do some detailing, which is what I'm going to do, to bring it out. A little bit of dry brushing on there will bring all that detail right out. We've got the beautiful upper decks here, all molded in black to look like the Black Pearl, if you so wish. Have the kiddos build this right out of the box, then get one for yourself and build it so that it's a little more detailed. Look at the railings on there. Beautiful. Just lovely detail. No issues at all with anything. Nice big trees. We got the wood-colored parts for the ship's wheel, some vents, some tie-offs there, and then we've got the gold-colored parts for trim. These are all going to get repainted. The Black Pearl herself should be white, so that will be painted by me. The lanterns and everything. We'll throw some coats of paint on stuff. Now I'm going to soak everything in some simple green just to degrease it, and we'll be back for some assemblies. It only takes a few minutes, especially when you're having a good time, and it's been so long since I've built a pirate ship that I'm really enjoying myself going through and planning my build and everything. I've assembled a few things before I'm going to start getting paint on everything. And something like a pirate ship is a lot of hand painting and detailing. It's not like a car where I can go ahead and spray paint a massive amount of stuff and details and get it ready. This is going to be basically overcoating everything with spray paint. One, to take off that shine. Two, to give me a tooth. The plastic's pretty smooth. When you try to dry brush over things that are smooth, the paint always doesn't want to grab as your brush passes over. And the secret of dry brushing is that you use such a light touch with the brush and so little bit of paint, the surface actually needs to have that tooth on it to grip what you're trying to brush onto it. So we've got the first deck, the cannon deck, installed. We're never going to see anything except for these cannons here. So there's absolutely no hand painting done in here. All I'll be doing after this is all painted is giving all the cannon a little bit of a gray brush to bring them out, and then they'll be sealed in there forever. The Black Pearl is assembled, and I've been using just a little bit of Tamiya Extra Thin with its super small applicator in there because I want to get into the small areas and just make sure that it kind of fills the gap of any seams, and any other seams on here we're really not going to worry about. The lanterns are put together right there. The rest of this material here, these braces for the cabin and decorations, are all going to be painted gold. The Black Pearl will be primered black and then painted white. Everything here is pretty much going to be primered black and then painted over with another color for our shadows. The sides of the hull are beautiful. I've attached all these boards that the shrouds and the rat lines connect to, and just using a little bit of that glue to attach them. They push in nicely. They have nice locating pins on the insides, so you're not going to have to worry about a lot of the attachment points. But again, If I'm here, I might as well use a little bit of glue since I plan on going a little bit farther with the kit. The main deck, I've assembled the door to the captain's quarters and the ladders. These ladders do push in quite tricky and they are a little fragile on the front and the back here. So what I did was I applied a little bit of glue to where the post goes in and then shove it in and they melt together beautifully. So I've got that. I've got the front of the deck on. Our mast is going to go in there, so we won't do anything more with that. But the railings are very fine on there. They're nice detailed. So that deck is ready. That will be primered black and then it will be covered with a more of a wood tone, and then I'll be darkening it quite a bit later. We've got our ship's wheel assembled. I just want to get those two pieces glued together tightly. This will all be painted a wood tone to take that plastic shine off. Everything else here is going to be primered in black, all the other parts we saw. The only thing that's not going to get hit with a spray paint are the beautiful sails. Those I will be actually clearing with a flat clear. One to help get the shine down. It'll help a little bit, but also again to give me that tooth front and back so that I can actually get some dry brushing done. And we're going to be doing a lot of dry brushing. We need a lot of towels for this. There are some decals in the kit that I didn't talk about earlier. They are vinyl. They are pirates flags. Decide if you want to use them. I most certainly will be using them. I'm not sure if I'm going to flat coat them or not because they are a little shiny, but it all depends. But I definitely want the skull and crossbones on there. So we've got our cannons. Those will be all painted flat black. So we'll the decks up here, the Widow's Walk, the Crow's Perch, and all that stuff. So we're going to get the rat lines flat coated so they're not so super shiny. Though in real life, they were kind of coated with tar and oil. But we're going to get them a little flatter because they're not plastic shiny in real life. So let's go over to the paint area. There won't be very much to do, but it'll be fun.
Some time to blow the man down.
you'll be able to see the differences in the paint pretty quick. Just with that flat coat, we're already getting a little bit of a more light gray tone from the sails, which is going to look great. Nowhere near as shiny as it used to be, and that's awesome. You can really see the effect when we go to the black coated flat black hull compared to how shiny the plastic was. All you're going to see is the cannon sticking out of here, so we're going to give those some dry brushing. The deck looks awesome with its black and pre-shaded. You can definitely see the other side wasn't touched, and you can see that the stark difference in those shades. Now, with dry brushing, all it is you take a very stiff brush, and I've gone over this in numerous other reviews, including the auto car review that I just did before this one. You dab it in some paint, you wipe off most of the paint on a paper towel. Then with it's got just a hint of paint left on the stiff brushes. Stiff brushes work the best because of the fact that they won't fall into every nook and cranny. They'll mostly ride above it. Then what we'll end up doing is we'll gently, don't ram it into the surface, we'll gently go back and forth, and anywhere you see raised detail is where it will start to catch, and the creases where it should be darker will not catch, and we'll start doing detail like that. We're going to go in and do some washes as well. Washes is where you take one part paint, 50% Windex or water, whatever the preferred thinner medium is for the paint you are using. I use craft paint, so it will be 50% paint, 50% Windex, just because it breaks up the paint better than just straight water. Alcohol and Windex and the ammonia will mix that up a lot better. Then we will apply it loosely, we'll dip a brush into it, and we'll slather the whole surface, let it sit for a few minutes, and then we'll gently wipe it off. Now I'm going to start working on techniques like that, and we'll come back and show you how those look. I won't just tell you about it, but you can see the warm gold on all the lanterns and the eaves of the cabins, and the braces looks a lot more realistic than the plastic. The plastic looks nice, but I prefer to just go a little bit farther. And with the black detail underneath it, we get a lot of that pre-shadowing. You can really see the pre-shadowing on the figurehead. She really stands out nicely now, so we won't have to do much with her at all. She looks great when you get that white over the top of it. We've got that russet brown on a lot of the extra wood details. We'll be doing some washing and dry brushing to bring those out. So after this point, it's just a lot of hand brushing, detailing, dry brushing, using all different kinds of colors. So I'm going to get to work on that, and I will be stepping back here and there and showing you different sections of that build. We'll see you soon. I told you I'd come back, show you some of the stuff as it goes along. Now the hull is quite a ways along, and you can see some different colorations compared to that black we had. You can see the nice hull on there. That looks real nice. Now I'm just using three basic colors and a wash. Now I have some pre-manufactured washes that it's just a very loose mixture of paint and thinner. Now I bought these when they went out of business a long time ago, but you can just take brown paint and half Windex and do that as well. If you happen to have access to any kind of real washes from manufacturers, go ahead and use them. So I've been using a gray storm, a raw umber, a drizzle gray to work on the hull and the sails. That's it. I brown washed the tan hull when I first started, covered the whole thing, then wiped a bunch of it off so I had some dark streaks where people would be walking and beating the ship up. Then, over the top of that, I started dry brushing the raw umber and the gray storm. And I also used the gray storm on the cannons, just the cannons and nothing else, to bring out their detail. On the other ships I've done some brightly painted cannons, because that's how the Queen's Navy and the U.S. Navy, they had them painted up real nice. But these are pirates, and in the movie everything is really subdued, so I didn't put any bright colors on the bases of the cannon or anything like that, even though I really wanted to. I wanted to do brass cannons, but I figured just dry brush them. I've been using two brushes. The cool thing about dry brushing is you can mix and match. You put so little paint on the brush by the time that you're working on it that you don't have to worry about what colors you have on next. You can just go and start using them. And as you can see on the paper towel, I wipe almost all of it off, and there's my three colors all the way across. So what I've been doing is dipping it in my paint, rubbing most of it off on my paper towel, and then going in and detailing. I detailed the whole deck all on its own. Then I took the hull sides and attached them and put the deck in. Then I put the cannons in, and now I've been weathering the deck itself as one piece. And even though the bottom of the hull and the upper deck are two separate pieces and there's no glue, you can actually see that the join line is right along that large seam, the water line right there. So you don't even notice it. You don't notice that it's been pressed together. There's no gap. There's no issue there. We're not having any kind of a problem. Then I used russet all over the hull to just bring it down and make it look a little more like wood. And we can see a difference here. Reach across. There's the black, and there's the dry brushed hull. So you can see the difference between the two colors. And you'll definitely see it at the end in the slideshow when we can get some generous lighting on it. So we've got that all mixed up. We've got that all weathered up. The deck is ready to go. We can start bolting stuff to the deck. For the hull, also a neat little detail to make some streaking marks and staining is I took the drizzle gray, rubbed most of it off, and started gently pulling down underneath everything and creating my light spots on the hull, where you'd have water and seaweed and salt water and whatever gunk being washed out the sides. You can see it all streaking the hull as it goes down. So again, a lot of subdued colors on this model, a lot of gentle coloration. We're not going for any stark contrast. On the sails, you can see that I've dry brushed them. What I did was I took some of the drizzle gray on a bigger brush, rubbed it off on the paper towel, and then streaked it back and forth. And by doing so, we didn't touch the low areas and only hit the high areas front and back. Then that was a little bright for me, so using another brush, I went back and got some of the darker gray, rubbed most of it off, and went up and down this time. And that will subdue your colors. So if you ever don't like how light of a color you put on or how dark, just go with a contrasting color and dry brush it and rub it back and forth, and you'll end up darkening and deepening that color. And the sails come out looking pretty tight. I mean, they're not bad at all. I like them. I like plastic sails to begin with. They're easy to work with. And I like that subdued gray, beat up kind of white. We'll look at the difference between the two. You can see I'm bringing out more detail just very subtly. So it's better than just plain gray on there. And all I had to do was flat coat that to get it to hold. So I'm going to keep working like that. I'm going to keep working on it. I've got to do the same to the back of the hull. I've got to paint in the windows so they look like they have lights on. Then I will attach them. Then we'll go ahead and do the dry brushing technique. Some of it will fill the glass with the yellow in it for the light, and that is perfect. It'll subdue that lighting so it's not as stark. And then I have to get some gold colored and dry brush really lightly over that to bring out all that beautiful detail. We'll be able to see it a lot better. Same with the lifeboat. We'll go ahead, do that up, get that attached to the hull. We'll just keep working. When the hull is ready to start mounting the masts and the ratline shrouds on there, then we'll come back for another look. Coming back at you with an update. We've got the hull done and it looks awesome. I did some green shading on the bottom as well, just using the dry brushing. Very, very subtle. I enhanced a little bit of the streaking. I thought it would show up better on camera. We've got the cabin on and that looks awesome. Just craft painted some yellow back there. Did some gold dry brushing. Got the windows in. Got all the braces for the cabins in. I only broke one and had to glue it. So that's looking spectacular. The deck is all outfitted with its equipment. And it looks absolutely wonderful. I'm loving this kit so far. I think it's just great. Now, I've been using mostly craft paints, except for this Sail Clearance Create Effects wash, and you could make your own wash. So for the investment in all these paints, there's about 9 paints here. I spent about as much as you would on these, getting them when they're on sale, 50 cents a bottle, you know, 75 cents a bottle, as you would spend on about one bottle of really expensive model paint. So that's where I save a lot of money, and you can make a lot of messes and a lot of mistakes. Also, the great thing about these craft paints is, even after they've dried hard, as long as you don't seal them, if you really hate your work, if you weather this deck or this hull and you're like, oh God, or you think you went too far with some streaking or dry brushing, Just take some water and wipe it off. Use a Q-tip, wipe it off one spot. Soak the whole thing in hot water and soap, and it'll all wash off relatively easy with a little bit of scrubbing. If you really want to remove it straight down to the bare plastic, then you can just soak it in some Purple Power or some Super Clean, and everything will immediately come off. It's really easy to get off. I've got the masts here dry brushed. It's hard to see the detail. I used a milk chocolate paint right there. It's a nice brown to highlight the ropes that hold the masts from cracking as they go. And then I dry brush the whole thing just so we have more of a wood tone on those masts and yard arms, because those will get replaced more often than the actual hull and other components will. I also use some dark brown russet on the attachment points and the pulleys for the yard arms and the shrouds. It's okay if I got the name wrong. You know exactly what you're looking at. So, and I also dry brush those to bring them out a little lighter over the black. I haven't done anything with the anchors yet. Those will be done pretty close to the end. But we're going to start attaching all that stuff now. I've got the Widow's Walk or the Crow's Nests all weathered up, ready to go on top there. Those will slide in. The stand I'm just leaving black because there are no emblems on it. It doesn't say anything. There's no decals. The lanterns will be one of the last things to go on. One of the very last things to go on of assembly will be that beautiful masthead. We're leaving her just as she is. I've been doing some more weathering to the sails. Check them out. They're actually looking pretty good. I've started to streak them down with a darker stain. All I've been using for that is the craft color called Wrought Iron. Folk art. These are 50 cents a bottle at Walmart. Just streak them down, streak them down, streak them down, and get them the way you want. So, and those look pretty good to me. So those are going to start to go on. One of the best ways, you can see it better on the back on the concave side. One of the best ways to shade and rub in craft acrylics once you have them on, because they are water-based, they're non-toxic, use your fingers. Use your thumbs. Rub it on there. Put your finger on it. Get it down. Burnish it in. Work it in, and then they'll come right off your hands with some dish soap. I'm going to get the masts on, the sails on, and then I'm going to rig it. But once I get the masts up and the sails on, we'll let you take one look at it again before I start putting some string on it, and we will be all done. I'll see you soon. We're almost done. Well, actually, if you wanted to build it right out of the box, aside from attaching the masthead right to the front here, which what I'm going to do last, you would be completely done with the ship. Just have to attach your flags. I flat coated those in anticipation of the final. But if you wanted to build it right out of the box and stop there, this is the beautiful ship you would have if you decided to do just a little bit of paint effects on it. Absolutely a stunner. Beautiful, beautiful kit. Goes together easily. No questions with fit or finish or any other problems. Now, I'm going to go do some very simple rigging using some plain old cheap sewing thread. And I'm just going to rig it to some points that's not going to be perfectly accurate. If it was real, the ship wouldn't fly. It wouldn't sail. But I'm just going to go ahead and run some ropes from the ends of the yard arms and the ends of the sails into certain points on the other yard arms and stuff, just so that I have a little bit of string on there so it looks a little more realistic. And when I get done with that, I will finally put that beautiful masthead on the front and call her done, and we'll be back for that final. So stay tuned just for a little bit longer. I'll be back. All done with Revell's 150th scale Pirates of the Caribbean Salazar's Revenge Black Pearl ship. Gave it my own little touch. Didn't do an exact perfect movie replica, but it's very close, and I love how it looks. We've got all kinds of cool rigging on there. I did it my own. I didn't follow any plan. There is no plan in the book or anything, so I did it on my own just to look semi-realistic, and that's why it's in front of that white background so that you guys can actually see that going back and forth. And all you have to do is just touch the end of it with some glue, run your line where you want, end up where you need to, and then touch it with glue again, and you're all done. I use super glue because it works fast and super easy. I like all the weathering I did on it. It comes out really nice. Looks like the movie ship with that white grayish stain to it. and it ends up being pretty darn cool. The weathering on the sails looks nice. Altogether, it looks like a beat-up pirate ship instead of a gorgeous ship of the line that you would normally see, excuse me, from a ship like a British ship or a U.S. ship of the day. It looks like it's been worn, weather-beaten, but it's got a lot of cannons and it's ready to fight and it's coming after your booty. So, this one I picked up online. They run less than $30 from Revell Germany. In the title will be the product number, so you can go out on the interwebs and find your own. And remember, build for yourself. Don't build for the guy online. Do what you want to do with it and enjoy it. And if you're happy when you're done with it, then you built that model the right way. Thanks for watching the workshop. We love all your support, your cool comments, your thumbs up, your subscriptions. And we will see you at the next model build review. Stay tuned for a very short slideshow after this video.